In this video, we are going to add config class for clients, resource, scopes, and test users definition on identity server 4. Let's take an action. First of all, we are going to create a new class, which name is config. This class will consist of different configurations related to users, clients, identity resources, and so on. So let's add them one by one. I'm going to right click. Add new class. We are adding the config class under the identity server project. Go to config class. Yes. In here we are going to define identity server for configurations. We will store all of the configurations in here. So let me copy and paste what configurations we should have. Yes, as you can see that first of all we have a client. Let me import this namespace identity server 4.models, and also let me import the test users namespace from the identity server package. So these are the configurations what we can define on the identity server 4: clients, API scopes and API resources, identity resources, and test users. We have already defined what is what purpose of these configurations in the previous video. So now we have configured with the config class. And we will change our startup CSS according to with config class. Go to startup class, and we were an empty list objects. Let me modify these configurations with the config class. Okay, now it is again with the empty list, but we are retrieving these configurations from the config class. And maybe you remember we have adding the developer signing credentials. It is provide to generate a certificate for us. As you can see that in here, tempk.gvkey is a temporary certificate. It is provide to running identity server in the HTTPS and give developer signing credentials. And now we can run our application and see what's happened. It is working fine or not. We will check the logs. Hit the F5 or you can click this one with the identity server running profile. Yes, as you can see that identity server 4 is running properly, and once we start our application, we are going to get information that our server is up and running and using in-memory grant type, and also we can verify that discover link is working or not. OpenID connect discover link, we will check from the postman. Let me open the postman again. Let me send a new request. Yes, we have also get the same response from the OpenID connect discover document. That means identity server is working fine properly. By the same way, you can create an identity server folder under our collection, postman collection, and we can save this get discover document in here. It is good to use under the our postman collection. We will follow the next HTTP get methods with this collection. We will extend this connection in the upcoming videos. So we have finished to developing standalone identity server project is running successfully. Of course, we should configure more according to our security requirements. For the next section, we will protect an API project with using identity server.